good to see you again. I'm glad that you have stopped by my Facebook page so that we could again study the Word of God. I'm Levi McClendon, pastor of Mount Zion All Nations Bible Church in DeWitt, Michigan. You're listening to The Truth That Transforms. It is an aspect of the teaching ministry of our church. I'm hoping that this time together will not only inform you, but will inspire you to continue to live out the life that Christ paid so dearly for with his own blood so that we might be what God has called us to be. Well, we've been studying the kingdom of God. We've been talking about what it is because we realize from scripture that we have been called into the kingdom, not just the church, but we are called into the kingdom of God. And so in order to respond in our lives and make this kingdom call a practical reality, we found out that we must first discover what the Lord means when he says the kingdom, when the apostles said the kingdom is at hand. As we, the church, preach and teach and live the kingdom, what does that mean? Well, we looked in the scripture and we found out from the book of Luke, Jesus said that the kingdom is not an event, it's not a location, if you will. We looked in Romans and Paul tells us that the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit, that it's not a matter of do's and don'ts, of eating and drinking, Paul says. So we find out that the first thing we must have a clear understanding of is what the kingdom of God is. Again, it is the rule and the reign of God in the lives and the hearts of men and women anywhere in the world where we have submitted to the lordship of Jesus Christ. That's the kingdom of God. In simple, wherever the will of the Lord is obeyed, there is where you'll find the kingdom of God. So having discovered the kingdom, the question becomes then, how do we become part, or how do you become part, or how does anybody become part of the kingdom of God? Well, let's look at one of our scriptures again in Matthew chapter 3, where John the Baptist, the last prophet of the Old Testament, preaches in the wilderness of Judea, proclaiming and heralding the preparation of the coming of the Lord Jesus. Listen to what John's first words are. Now remember that John is the first prophet to speak for 450 years, what we call in theological circles the intertestamental period, the period between the last book of the Old Testament writing, Malachi, and the first utterance of God to man under the new covenant or before the new covenant through John the Baptist. Listen to what he says. When John the Baptist came preaching, he says, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near." Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near. Listen to what John the Baptist says. He says, "The kingdom of heaven is near. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. The kingdom of heaven is close to you." But he says the prerequisite for receiving the kingdom is to repent. That's right, repent. Now listen to what he says. He says, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." The word repent here is a Greek word, which is really a combination. It's the word, it's metanoeo. The prefix meta, again, and noeo, from the Greek word, which means to think or the mind. So what is John the Baptist, Jesus, the apostles, what are we, the church, proclaiming when we say, "Repent, the kingdom of heaven is at hand"? Metanoeo, repent, think again. To repent means to change your mind and then to change your action. To change your attitude, and then to change your activity. Why would John the Baptist have to tell a Jewish audience who's been looking for the Messiah and the kingdom to first rethink the very kingdom they've been looking for. Well, let me suggest this to you, as we talked about in previous teaching. When the Jewish nation thought about the kingdom, they thought in terms of a political, military, socio-economical kingdom that would oppose and really overcome the Roman kingdom under which they had been subjects for so many years. So to them, the kingdom of God meant that we'll be just like the Romans, only we'll be in charge. John the Baptist comes to them and says, you got to rethink this thing. Because they were looking for their Messiah to be as ruthless, as domineering as the earthly kings and messiahs. They did not understand that the Messiah, Jesus Christ, did not come, first of all, to overthrow military kingdoms and political structures. But he came to give his life that we might be ushered in and have the opportunity to come into a spiritual kingdom. So John the Baptist says, you got to repent. You got to rethink it. And if we are going to be a part of the kingdom of God, it first demands that we, yes, even the church, we who are believers, we repent, we rethink. Not only does it mean to rethink, but it means also to change your activity. So let me give you three aspects of repentance. First of all, the first one we talked about, it is to rethink. To rethink about God, to rethink about who I am, to rethink about what I'm supposed to be doing, about what God created me to be, to rethink it. But then it means to regret, if you will, in this sense. To regret means I have to be sorry about my former way of life, my former way of thinking. I have to be sorry. I have to regret the fact that I've been living beneath my privileges, that I've been living lower than I should. I've got to understand that I belong in the house and I've been hanging out in the hog pen. So I have to rethink, re-understand, I have to regret, I have to say I'm sorry, but then I have to reverse. So watch it. I have to rethink, regret, and then reverse. Reverse. Turn around. Change my way of thinking, and then change my way of acting, then I'll change my direction. To desire the kingdom of God means I've got to come to the understanding that maybe it's not what I've always thought it was. Maybe the kingdom of God is not just joining a church and being baptized and becoming a part of some local ministry and giving a few dollars here and there and saying my prayers before I go to bed. It's more than that. The kingdom of God means that I totally, completely, and eternally surrender my life, all that I am, to Christ. That I rethink my condition, rethink my position, that I regret my life away from Him, my life apart from Him. That I reverse my situation. I make up my mind today. I'm no longer walking away from Him, away from His people, away from His will. But I'm going to begin to walk toward Him so that I can follow Him and walk with Him. Well, that's about it for today. But remember, the kingdom of God is at hand. If you're listening to me, Jesus is real. The kingdom of God is freely offered to you. Whosoever will, let him come. Bow your head and pray this prayer with me. Father, I realize that you gave your son that I might live. Today I accept your sacrifice. And I ask you to receive me into your kingdom. I repent, I regret, and I reverse. Now I want to walk with you. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. That's all the time we have now. I'll see you next time on The Truth That Transforms.